All right, what's up everyone? Coach Braden here with Look Like You Lift, and in this video, I'm gonna show you how you can get really massive, good-looking legs with just one exercise, and how to use that exercise to get massive legs. The squat. The squat is all you need to grow your legs. You don't need to be doing leg extensions, leg curls, kickbacks, hip thrusts, whatever. Ugh. You just need a really good squat. So I'm gonna show you the five steps to how to grow your legs a little bit faster. All right, so let's get into it. So number one, effective range of motion. Now, I'm emphasizing effective range of motion. I'm not looking for a full range of motion. So what's the difference? A full range of motion would be like ass to grass, where your butt has to touch the back of your legs. That it would not necessarily be the most effective range of motion, because to get down that deep, you have to have incredible mobility, you have to have the right shoes, and then you're also running the risk of relaxing certain muscle groups to get down that deep. Well, that kind of contradicts what we're trying to do. You can't grow a muscle if it's relaxed. So the most effective range of motion for 99% of people is getting all the way down where your hip crease is right in line with the top of your knee. You don't need to go ass to grass, but you sure definitely should not be going into a quarter squat. Go to your effective range of motion. That's step number one. Step number two, focus on getting stronger. A strong leg is a big leg. Think of it this way. Who's got the bigger legs? The person who squats 200 pounds or the person who squats 800 pounds, right? So if you can focus on increasing the weight that you're squatting every single time that you're in the gym and sticking to an effective rep range like five, we're a huge fan of fives, that's going to grow your legs the fastest, especially when you're just starting out. So get stronger. All right, so step number three is fix your cadence. So when we talk about cadence, we're talking about how fast you perform the movement. We're talking about how far you're descending, how long you hold the bottom, if there is a hold, and then how long it takes for you to ascend. A lot of people, as they get stronger, they start to speed through and rush through their sets. I'm gonna encourage you to slow it down. We're looking for time under tension. Now, I'm not talking about like a 10 second descent, a hold at the bottom, and then a 10 second ascent, because I'm not a believer that time under tension is what grows a muscle. I'm a believer that load grows a muscle. So control your descent and control your ascent. Don't speed through the repetitions. Number four, this is where you can vary the rep range. So once you've focused on improving your form with your squat, getting really freaking strong with your squat, and then you've made sure to do it with good, high quality, good speed repetitions, you can now vary the rep ranges. And we've talked about how muscle growth happens in all rep ranges, anywhere from one rep all the way to 20 reps. So we've stuck to fives for a while. Now I'm gonna encourage you to cycle through rep ranges anywhere from 2 to 8. That's a great place to start. And then when you're feeling really brave, you can go from 2 to 14. And if you're really ballsy and crazy, you can go from 2 all the way to 20, but vary your rep ranges here. So we've worked on your form. You've gotten really, really strong. You've played with different rep ranges. And now the last step, repeat. I want you to go back and repeat each one of these steps and constantly check on yourself to make sure that you're doing each one of these steps as effectively as you can. The most important thing here for any muscle group to grow is you have to progressively increase the resistance or make it a little bit harder every single time. For a lot of my beginners, the way that we do that is just by adding a little bit of weight to their squat every single time. As you get more advanced, we have to make it a little bit harder through slowing the movement down, varying the rep ranges, but the most important thing is that you continue to challenge your legs. So that's it, guys. Like I said, all you need to grow is just your squat. You don't need anything else. So I want you to comment down below, what's the most that you've ever squatted? I'm curious, I wanna know. Put that in the comment section and we'll see you in the next video. Thanks.